Today is Monday, November 3rd. I'm Stephanie Malconian. Virgin Galactic's Spaceship 2 crashed on Friday. We'll have the details.
And I'm Hannah Barr. How much did it rain on Saturday? Plenty, and it snowed at Bogus as well. Your CSN News starts now.
Galactic Spaceship 2, the first spacecraft designed to carry tourists to the edge of space, broke apart in mid-air during a test flight Friday and crashed to the ground. The debris field resulting from the tragic accident, which killed one Spaceship 2 pilot and injured the other, measures about 5 miles, 8 kilometers, from end to end, so large that the suborbital space plane could not have come down in one piece. Reports say that a part that helps bring the aircraft back to Earth may have developed during its launch. More answers should be forthcoming as the investigation continues. The investigators will likely spend 4 to 7 days examining the crash site, then about 12 months analyzing and interpreting what they've found, experts said.
A strong storm system brought record rainfall to the Boise area Saturday and several inches of snow to the mountains. The National Weather Service recorded 1.15 inches of rain at the Boise airport in the 24-hour period, breaking a record of 0.52 for that day in November, which was set back in 1950. According to the NWS, Saturday was also the single wettest day in November history. Rain turned to snow in the mountains, with several area ski resorts picking up several inches Saturday evening and overnight. Bogus Basin picked up 8 inches of snow, Bald Mountain and Sun Valley snagged 7 inches, and Brundage Mountain and McCall added 3 inches to the base of their mountain. Will that mean Thanksgiving skiing? No word yet. We'll let you know when we know.
Huge stone circles found in the Middle East have long baffled archaeologists. But researchers believe that recent aerial images of the huge circles could lead to crucial findings about the circles. Archaeologists in Jordan took images of 11 ancient big circles from above. The researchers found that one of the circles had a diameter of almost 1,312 feet. No one knows why the circles were built or who built them, but the similarity between these circles suggests that at some point they might have been interlinked to each other. It was found that the big circles are built with low stone walls without openings, which means you'd have to hop over the walls to enter. Analysis of the images taken recently suggested that the circles date back at least 2,000 years, but they could be much older. They could even have been constructed in prehistoric times before writing was invented, scientists say. We'll be right back after these messages.
If you're looking for information for financial aid or college, join us on Thursday 20th from 6 to 7 p.m. in the CHS library. Both parents and students are invited to attend to learn about types of financial aid, who gets financial aid, and how to apply for financial aid. Also, there will be a Spanish presentation for the non-English speakers. Financial aid reps from CWI and NNU will be there to answer your questions. This could be your first step to your college career. See you there!
Today's weather is brought to you by Dr. Kim Keller. Halloween means candy, and candy can mean cavities. Stop by Dr. Keller and see if you've got more holes in your head. Today's high is 54 with a low of 36, and tomorrow's high is 53 with a low of 37.
This Thursday through Saturday is our fall play, See How They Run, in the Little Theater at 7 each evening. Doors open at 6:30, and admission is $6 for adults or $5 for students. Don't miss a night of good theater and support our drama department.
The Nampa School District BPH chapter will be having a meeting tomorrow, Tuesday, November 4th, at 3 o'clock in Mr. Rutherford's room at 103. We'll be discussing registration and competitive events.
Attention seniors, if you or your parents want to put a personalized page in the yearbook, pick up an order form in the office. These ads can be anything you want, from adorable baby photos to professional senior photos and a message from your parents to you. All ads must be paid in full by December 5th. Please pick up an order form and submit the ad and photos to Mrs. Levi in room 201. Order forms are in the office.
You need to have your ID card with you at all times. Beginning Wednesday, students without ID cards will be asked to return to the end of the lunch line, and the students who do have their ID cards will go through first. You can also register with the cashier for finger scanning. Please remember to always have your ID card with you. Just like a driver's license, you never know when you may need it, and should always have it with you.
Today's SAT word of the day is amicable, a verb that means friendly or peaceful.
You can use it this way. Despite their divorce, the couple remained in amicable terms, meeting for dinner and a movie once a month.
That's your news. We'll see you again right here on the Bulldog Edition.